Donnie and Dolly. The team is supported by AbleAuctions.ca. Closing your business? We can help. And King of Floors, your vinyl, laminate, and engineered flooring superstore.
Just ahead of Daren Millard, Donnie and Dolly presented by Able Auctions. If you have assets, inventory, or equipment you need to sell, email sales at ableauctions.ca. And King of Floors, your vinyl, laminate, and engineered flooring superstore. Several people texting
referencing
in.
The cane.
I should have had the cane out for my old man rant regarding what happened
beer.
Last night at the Nassau Coliseum.
Yeah.
Our cane sponsored, by the way. Yes, we have a cane sponsor. It's Delaney's OK Tire in Langley. Some people also making the point that in most NHL buildings, I think maybe all NHL buildings, concession sales stop at the start of the third period. But there was an issue with the bathrooms last night.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for that update.
Whatever the case may be. But those beers look fairly full. I guess you could buy 10 of them at a time. Okay. Let's talk with Daren Millard now. Vegas Golden Knights TV host. Game 6, Golden Knights versus the Habs tonight in Montreal.
Yep.
Habs up 3-2. They can advance to the Stanley Cup Final for the first time since 1993. Daren Millard, like I said, television host down there in Vegas, and probably best known as a co-host, a contestant on Ice Picks back in the day.
I wasn't a contestant.
I don't know. What do we call ourselves?
We were participants.
Okay.
Because we were on every week. It wasn't like it changed over. Well, one guy did a little bit, but most of us were there nonstop. Hey, I'm impressed Nassau County Coliseum still has running water
for
that's the bathrooms.
True.
Never
yeah.
mind.
Yeah.
When that place was first built, didn't they just have outhouses?
I believe they did. And then if you wanted a drink of water, there was a well in the back.
Yeah.
So it's...
Yeah. Yeah. And until the dog fell down, and then they had to stop.
That's right.
CNN. Yeah. That's how CNN got famous, was saving the dog from the well at Nassau Coliseum.
Yeah, yeah. It has its flaws. There's a reason they're moving to another building, or that
brand
they went
new
to Brooklyn in the first place. But, man, it is great to watch on television. I can't imagine what it's like. I've been there for games,
Keith Jones had Keith Jones had the best line. He said, at least finish your beer before you chuck the can on the ice.
Yeah,
that's a good point.
Well, apparently, what we're hearing, Daren, is that people were upset because a lot of them, that's why they were throwing the debris on the ice, because they were upset. They missed it because I guess the concessions were closed, I'm sure, but they were bathroom lineups. So the building has its flaws. All right.
How many people were in the bathroom lineup?
Like, if you want to gamble,
thrown on the ice.
Yeah,
that's a gamble to go to the can before overtime. It's a gamble.
Now you're agreeing with me.
I will say this, if you're willing to throw a can of beer on the ice, I'm surprised you even tried to go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
didn't just use the cup there. So there's a contradiction there.
Hey, Daren, before we get to the Habs and the Golden Knights, had you heard the name Dave Hakstol at all in connection with the Seattle Kraken?
Nope. That was completely under the radar.
Out of the blue.
We were so focused on people that were former head coaches and currently out of work. And Dave Hakstol was an assistant coach, even though he'd coached in the National Hockey League as a head man in Philadelphia. But no, it kind of fits the mold of when you look at it now in revisionist history. It's not a big surprise, but... I'll fully admit I hadn't heard Dave Hakstol's name mentioned around there. So good on them for keeping it tight-lipped.
All right, on to tonight. Knights and Habs. Knights, shockingly for I think most people, facing elimination. Daren, you're a goaltender, old goaltender, and as I mentioned, used to work at Ice Picks.
And Sportsnet.
Who starts in goal tonight for the Golden Knights?
It sure sounds like it's going to be Robin Lehner. I don't think it's the biggest story that's a non-story, and it's a story because you guys know it just doesn't happen where you switch goaltenders in a Stanley Cup playoff. It never happens, and it certainly doesn't happen when you're in a situation like Marc-Andre Fleury was playing well, and then Robin Lehner goes in, you do make the switch, and he stands on his head, and you go get back to the other guy. So it's a story because it's so unusual. It's not a story because there's no more risk in starting Robin Leonard than Marc-Andre Fleury. And what I mean by that is you run the same risk of Marc-Andre Fleury having an off night if you go back to him as you do Robin Leonard having an off night if you go to him. Like, they're just so at the top of the game when it comes to giving yourself the biggest chance or best chance to win. So it's either one. There's no wrong decision, and it's up to the athlete to make sure that the coach is rewarded for giving that particular player the opportunity. But we're so accustomed and groomed to the same goaltender going out, and even during the regular season, yeah. One of the normal questions is Trey Travis, who's playing goal tonight? Like, we're fascinated by it. I don't think goaltending necessarily has the same intrigue as starting pitchers or the ability to dictate a game. But in this case, I think it's the same level of chance of winning is even with between Robin and Mark.
Hey, Darren, let's focus on the other end of the ice right now and Carey Price.
Yep.
And you tell me, the one thing I haven't seen the Golden Knights do, I think they're giving him too much respect. I haven't seen them creating traffic in front of Carey Price. Have I got that right?
Donnie, yeah, you're right. And I'll double down on it. I don't think Carey Price has been a difference in the series. Mm-hmm. Or had to be a difference in the series. So there's the good and the bad. I think there's been a couple of goals. I think back to game three and the Marc-Andre Fleury faux pas behind the net. Mm-hmm. The only reason the Golden Knights had a lead in that game is because Alex Pietrangelo, good shot, but coming down the middle of the ice, scored from 45 feet. That's an unusual goal on Carey Price. I don't think he's been as lights out as we would have expected him to have been if the Montreal Canadiens were going to have a 3-2 series lead going home at the start of the series. If you would have told me that Montreal can have a chance to clinch in game six, I would have said Carey Price is all world. He hasn't had to be and hasn't been so far. Part of that is the Golden Knights not getting to the front of the net. And if they get power play tonight, I anticipate that they will jam that net as much as possible. To try and chain things up. It's been an interesting series, and that's the other part that's scary. I still think Vegas can win the series. I think that they can flip the switch. Three games in a row, this would be the third off game. That just doesn't happen with this group. So that's why I think they'll bounce back tonight. But the sort of thing, devil looking over your shoulder, is Carey Price hasn't stolen a game yet. And when does that happen?
Darren, some stats that just blow me away. Vegas, no power play goal in seven games.
Yeah.
Their top six, one goal in this series. That was Pacioretty last game. Mark Stone, no points in five. What's going on with that elite-level top six group not producing?
I think part of it can be pointed to the absence of Chandler Stephenson, who does make – he's not that prototypical number one center. And when outside the organization look at this team, they'll say they need that number one center. Well, Chandler Stephenson is that because he gets the most out of Pacioretty and Stone, who both have had career years. So I think that's a little misguided point of that, but he didn't play for three games. A part of the lack of production can be pointed to that. And when Chandler Stephenson missed three games because of the suspension during the regular season, the production fell off from the big line. So there's that aspect of it. Then there's the other part where I think that those two players, and Stone in particular, is feeling the weight of the power play. And the power play has been the only real flaw, and it wasn't a flaw during the regular season, but things went so great on every level with this team that the only real thing that you could pick at was, why isn't the power play as good as the penalty killing and the goaltending and the defense? And so it became a story, and now it's mushroomed during the Stanley Cup playoffs. And I think Mark Stone, as much as anybody, is carrying the weight of the lack of performance and lack of confidence of that power play, and it may be influencing some of his five-on-five play. And that's where I think that some of his drawback has come from. And I'll use the whole, like, I don't know who's healthy, who's not, but Stone looks like he's okay. He made a power move to the net the other night, and it just rolled off his stick. So he's getting these plays. Their power play, though, I think is really seeped into the confidence of their overall game.
Daren, I'm going to guess that Seattle is going to pray and hope for the success of Vegas. Vegas has had a tremendous run with so many victories, so many playoffs, going deep the whole nine yards. The NFL's there. The NBA, I presume, could be there soon. I presume the Major League Baseball could end up there. Tell us a little bit about Vegas as a hockey market right now.
Yeah, it's hot because the Golden Knights came in and they sell out every game. And my description of the atmosphere is when the puck stops moving, it's a nightclub. And when the puck goes back into play, it becomes a hockey game again. But in between whistles, it is the most electric, craziest, unique atmosphere in the world. Like you guys probably remember like Crazy George.
He would get the
people fired up. Well, you can't tell the difference between who's Crazy George at T-Mobile and who's a regular fan, because the regular fans get all dressed up and get into it, and it's a night out, it's a club night for everybody. So it's I'm so happy and privileged to be able to be in that arena every night, and then you trickle it down, and the Vegas Golden Knights have a practice facility which has two sheets of ice that they go at, and the Henderson Silver Knights, they moved their American Hockey League affiliate here this past winter. They're just on the other side of town in Henderson. They have two practice or two sheets of ice, and they're jammed. And I'm talking my desk overlooks one of the sheets, and it's going nonstop. The minor hockey market, it's been really impressive. And when you look at the bumper stickers and T-shirts and things like that are a barometer, but what's noticeable is they're everywhere. And you would think that this team had been around for 50 years, like Vancouver or some franchise of that elk, instead of just four.
Daren, before we let you go, I have to ask you this very quickly. We're out of time here, but you mentioned the atmosphere.
Well, first time that I've been back on with you guys. This has been great. I love it.
Yeah, we'll have to start paying you. That's why. Daren, you mentioned the atmosphere at Vegas. It's great and all that, but for the first time that I can remember, last time out,
got booed.
Got booed. What was that all about?
Second time that I can remember in my 2 years there being booze. The other one was, I believe, a St. Louis game 2 years ago when things weren't going great. It was a power play. It was the end of the period. Yep. People were frustrated. And as I told a caller to the post game the other day, I asked him, I said, did you boo? Yeah. When was the last time you booed? I've never booed. I'm like, okay, you're 4 years in. It's the conference final or the Stanley Cup semifinals, and that's the first time you booed. You've got it pretty good. Yeah. You've earned your right.
Come to Vancouver.
They were, yeah, exactly. Yeah, or any other market. Like people, that's what people do. It was noticeable. It was a story here, and it is a story here. People aren't happy about it. The players certainly weren't pleased that their play was met with that. But I think that given the grand scheme of it, playing Montreal, you're a heavy favorite, and you're having trouble scoring or generating anything in the power play. It's almost like the crowd gained its wings a little bit, and they became like that that next step. Goalie controversy and booing, two things that you can't be a legitimate fan base without doing.
Yeah, welcome to the NHL. Daren, thanks for this.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
Hey, congratulations, you guys. Big fan, and really proud of what you guys have been doing.
Thanks, Daren.
Thank you, Daren.
Appreciate it, my friend. Right back at you.